أحب أتمشى بشوارع قطر، أحب أجواءها، نبض الحياة فيها. كل أسبوع رح أخذكم إلى عالم سيدات قطريات قياديات وسيدات المجتمع الدبلوماسي في قطر. نتعرف على عاداتهم وثقافة بلدانهم، وأيضاً نتعرف على الجانب الاجتماعي والشخصي لحياتهم. تبون تعرفون وين بنروح اليوم؟ اليوم راح نلتقي بالسفيرة غراسيلا غوميز غارسيا، سفيرة الولايات المتحدة المكسيكية، بلد مليء بالثقافات المتعددة والعادات الأصلية. نرحب فيك سعادة السفيرة غراسيلا غوميز غارسيا، في سفيرة الولايات المتحدة المكسيكية في دولة قطر. يا هلا ومرحبا.
السلام عليكم. Welcome to our house. It is a real honor having you here. And please, as we say in Mexico, let me start by offering you a little bit of a Mexican coffee. This is your home. You are welcome.
شكرا. إذا سعادة السفيرة، بداية خليني أسألك، لما عرفتي أنك راح تجين قطر، إيش كان انطباعك الأول أو تصورك عن قطر؟
Coming to Qatar was a big surprise for me. It was the first time I was coming to the region. It was the first time I was coming to the country. And at the beginning, I was really nervous about what it will be like. Ever since I arrived, everybody has been so welcoming to me that I felt at home from the beginning.
سعادة السفيرة، كيف وجدتي الجو في قطر؟
I have to say everybody told me about the weather in Qatar. But I grew up in Venezuela, in a tropical country with a very warm weather. I love it. Also, before coming here, I was living in Boston for 6 years. And believe me, 6 winters were too much for me. So I was very happy to be back in a country with a nice and warmer weather.
وفي سؤال آخر ودي أسألك إياه، بما أن شفتي الكثير عن المرأة القطرية، فكيف هو انطباعك عن المرأة القطرية بما أنك واجهتي كذا مرأة، استمعتي لكذا مرأة، شفتي كذا مرأة، فإيش هو انطباعك وتصورك عن المرأة القطرية؟
Thank you for asking me. That has been one of the best surprises, of the most pleasurable parts of my job in Qatar. I've met so many amazing Qatari women. They are professional, they are strong, they are very beautiful, and they are particularly very helpful. Ever since I arrived in Qatar, women everywhere have been opening doors for me, have been offering their support, have been welcoming me like a sister. So I've been delighted to work with women, and I'm looking forward to meet even more.
انطباعك جميل عن المرأة القطرية، وقلتي فعلا شيء فيها، وأن عاملوك كأخت، وهذا شيء مرحب فيه معك ومع الجميع في قطر. وهذا ينقلني لسؤال آخر عن المرأة المكسيكية، فعرفينا على المرأة المكسيكية.
I see lots of similarities. Mexico was a very traditional society. We have been evolving in the recent years a lot. So more and more Mexican women are now moving into professional positions. We have also invested a lot, like Qatar have done, in educating girls. We do believe in the importance of education for girls. And as a result of that, I see that we have many ways of identifying each other. As I said, we come from traditional societies in which family is very important. So one thing I see we have in common is that we always care a lot for our families. Friends also become like family, and we want to have some professional development as well.
سعادة السفيرة، كونك مرأة دبلوماسية بعد يوم طويل وشاق في العمل، كيف تقضين باقي وقتك مع عائلتك وخاصة في الويكند؟
Well, for me, it has been always about balance. I love what I do in my diplomatic life, but I also adore my family. And it's always nice to try to find a balance. So typically we try to go out. We love eating in restaurants. So every weekend we will try to make a consultation about where to go. This is an important part. And then of course we try to do something exciting, to explore, maybe going to a museum, maybe going to a new place that we want to discover. We call them adventures. And of course during COVID, life became difficult.
Right.
So we have become more fans of doing puzzles, of watching TV, doing video games, but it's all about balancing.
عند انقضاء عملك في قطر، ايش اللي ودك تاخذينه كتجربة قطرية تاخذينها وتنقلينها للمكسيك؟
Wow, that is a lovely question. Every time I lived in a country, I always bring something back with me. And when I come back to Mexico after Qatar, I want to bring a little bit of this sense of hospitality, of this warmth I have received. But also, hopefully, I will be able to learn some Arabic by then. So I want to keep that. I love your language. And the third thing I would like to do also is maybe to be able to cook some traditional Qatari dishes. I would love to cook for my friends some dishes from the region.
نعم إن شاء الله. يومك الطويل في العمل ما بين المنزل ما بين العمل، إحنا ودنا أيضا نتعرف أكثر على مكتبك، فخلينا ناخذ جولة في السفارة.
Absolutely. Please, let's go. Welcome to my office.
ما شاء الله مكتبك يعني مليان من الألوان. أعتقد هذا هو التراث المكسيكي.
This is exactly what I wanted to achieve. This is where I work, and this is what I wanted to bring a little bit of what Mexico is. As you can see, we have different regions. We have all kinds of textiles. For example, here you can see this is done by hand. Mm-hmm. This is done by women artisans, and as you can see, the patterns are not so different from the ones we have here in the Middle East. I also wanted to create a cactus garden because Mexico has jungles, has lots of different vegetation, but we also have deserts. So for me, this is a nice reminder of something that we have in common. Mm-hmm. And along with the plants of the desert, I also have here my beautiful flower of the desert, the rose of the desert, which is also very nice. And I wanted every visitor who comes to my office to feel a little bit the colors, the warmth, the richness of Mexico.
Mexico. وحكينا عن اللوحات، يعني هذه اللوحات بعد مليانة ألوان، ثلاث لوحات مختلفة، لكن الألوان وجود المرأة أيضا في اللوحات.
This one, for example, represents motherhood. It's all about this idea of nurturing, soft curves, soft, beautiful colors. I really like it. And we also have this other part of the series. For me, this is a lovely combination between the earth colors, yeah, but also the seashells. You see this evocation of the sea, and it's one of my favorites. I really, really like it. And the third one in the series is this girl who is a flower seller. Again, it's all very warm colors, very nice. And she happened to have what is my favorite flower. In Mexico, we call them alcatraces. And all together, I think they add a little soft touch. If Mexico is having a female ambassador, I think it's nice to have a nice decoration.
سعادة السفيرة، قلتي لي هذه المرة الأولى اللي تم تعيينك كسفيرة وفي دولة قطر. مثلتي بلدك كدبلوماسية في كم دولة؟
Well, actually, this is the first time I am an ambassador. It's my first position an ambassador. And of course, I couldn't be more honored that this is my first time as an ambassador in Qatar. But I joined the Foreign Service a long time ago. I actually became a diplomat when I was 23 years old. And I have been in different positions in London. I was at the Mexican embassy for 4 years. Then I moved to Switzerland, was at the embassy there for nearly 9 years. Then I went back to Mexico. And after that, I went to Boston in the United States for 6 years. So right after Boston, my new home is Qatar.
ما شاء الله، هذه حياة حافلة كمرأة، فكونك مرأة يعني متزوجة كزوجة وأم، كيف قدرتي تخلقين هذا التوازن ما بين العائلة وأيضا ما بين تنقلاتك كسفيرة؟
Thank you for the question. This is very important. For me, my life, my family is my inspiration, and but I also love my work very much. So I always try to make sure that I am professional in all levels, as a mother, as a wife, of course, as a diplomat. And I always try to make sure that I remember that I'm here to serve Mexico, but I'm also here because of the support I receive from my family.
Well, Graciela and I have been married for over 20 years, and it has been an amazing journey we've been on. I think this is our fourth country that we've lived in, and we have this wonderful family, this group of boys who come with us. And she has always been so committed both to her work and to us as a family. And of course, as a diplomat, it's a very complex role, different challenges every day, different people to work with and partner with. And so there are times when, many times when she's super professional and I'm not involved. But of course, for anyone in a leadership role, there are times when the way forward isn't clear or where there's some stress and uncertainty. And that's where I can come in and give her some encouragement, sometimes a push. And that's my role, to be ready in those moments. And of course, I'm myself and my boys, we're so proud of what she's achieved and the role that she plays and how she represents her country.
Well, I arrived here in Qatar almost exactly a year ago, and ever since, life has been very dynamic for me. I've been working a lot in my free time as a volunteer and as an intern in different sports organizations. And I've just really enjoyed my life here, being able to meet people from all over the world. And the main way I've done that is through playing football, one of my favorite hobbies here. I was honestly very surprised at how big the football scene is here. Through working behind the scenes in several sports events here in Qatar, I am absolutely impressed at the dedication that Qatari people and the Qatari community has for sports here, how it brings the whole community together and how the whole country seems to be united in the effort toward creating a fantastic venue for the 2022 World Cup and many more events to come after that and before then as well.
So yeah, from what I like here in Qatar is just, again, using my hobby of photography to go out and about and photograph things that very worth eye-catching to see out there in Qatar. For example, last weekend I decided to go out for a walk, and one of the things I decided to do is walk around Corniche. And yeah, I brought my camera along with me to photograph the skyline of Qatar, seeing all the skyscrapers on the other side, and yeah, it's very interesting to see.
هذه الحياة العائلية بالتأكيد تأخذك لأماكن داخل قطر. فإيش أفضل وأحب مكان إلى قلبك في قطر؟
My favorite place in Doha is Qatar.
بما أن أفضل أماكنك قطر، عيل خليني أوديك قطر.
Excellent.
تفضلي.
Let's go.
إذن وصلنا لقطر، المكان اللي تحبينه سعادة السفيرة غراسيلا. ممكن تقولين لي ليش تحبين قطر؟
I love everything about قطر. قطر for me is one of the most important places because I come here for work. We do a lot of art exhibitions, concerts. We have had a Mexican dancing group exactly in this scenario a few months ago. But I also come here with my family. I come here to relax. It's such a beautiful place. It's full of architecture. I love culture. And architecture in Doha is very rich.
صحيح.
A few people don't know, for example, that Education City, some of the campuses of the universities were designed by a Mexican architect by the name of Eduardo Legorreta. So in art, I think we always communicate, and there is always a way of finding a language that brings us together.
وبما أن نحن في قطر وقطر ملتقى للثقافات المختلفة، قولي لي عن ثقافة الأكل وهذه الثقافة الغنية عندكم في المكسيك.
That's correct. Here in Doha, we have lots of different cultures. And please let me take you to a wonderful Mexican restaurant. To try this. Let's go. Please welcome, and we are going to enjoy a very nice Mexican meal here in probably the best Mexican restaurant in Doha.
يعني المطعم ما شاء الله حلو، ومن خلال المطعم أنا أشوف إن الثقافة متمثلة في ثقافة الطعام. فحدثيني شوي عن ثقافة الطعام في المكسيك، خاصة إن هذا مطعم مكسيكي. بالتأكيد إنه هو يطبق هذه الثقافة من خلال أطباقه.
Mexican culture is very, very built around food. Food is extremely important. Food is something that brings people together, starting from the choosing of the ingredients, having the fresh ingredients, then bringing the family to cook in the kitchen. We like dishes that are very labor intensive, so normally they require a lot of collaboration in the kitchen. And of course, it is also a good excuse to bring the families together. It's all about food.
مرحبا.
Muchas gracias. If you're okay, I would like to choose for you.
أكيد.
So, vamos a hacer una pequeña selección de platillos para que mi amiga pruebe por primera vez la comida mexicana. Muchas gracias.
في ثقافة الطعام في المكسيك تجمع العائلة واللي عرفناه إن المكسيك فيها مشتهرة بالبهارات. إيش أنواع البهارات الموجودة في المكسيك؟
Well, in Mexico, we use a lot of chilies, for example. This is the most important spices for savory food. We have dozens of varieties of chilies in Mexico, both fresh and dry. And also for sweet, we like cinnamon a lot, for example. So, quite similar, I think.
صحيح، وأذكر القهوة اللي قدمتيها لي في البيت كان فيها طعم الدارسين. فهالمزيج ما بين القهوة والدارسين أول مرة أتذوقه، وأعتقد أني بطبقه في البيت علشان أتذوق الطعم المكسيكي دائما.
Indeed. And now we are trying horchata.
Horchata.
Horchata. This is a very refreshing water, and we drink it a lot with, with meals. It is made out of rice, you boiled rice, and it is seasoned with cinnamon.
دارسين مرة ثانية. هل نتذوق؟
Normally we will have our meals with very refreshing water, always.
نعم. لذيذ، نفس طعم الماء الورد تقريبا، منعش، واستخدمت الدارسين.
Very nice and refreshing.
أخيراً الأكل المكسيكي.
So, here is the food.
Wow.
Here comes the food. Wonderful. Look at
this. ملابسها حلوة.
Lovely dress.
تقليدي. مكسيكي تقليدي.
ما شاء الله.
يعني في تنوع في الأكل. خلينا نتعرف إذا بداية، كلميني عن هالأطعمة.
Lovely smell. We have a little a bit of a different things I wanted you to try. This is guacamole. It's made of fresh avocados. And with just a little bit of coriander, tomato, a little bit of onion. Delicious, very fresh. Here we also have barbacoa. This is one of my favorite dishes. This is from the region where my father comes from. Is a very, very slowly cooked lamb. Very nice. And here we have a nice molcajete. Molcajete is this thing is made out of stone.
Stone.
And you normally put here a combination of vegetables and meat. Very nice. And always we finish the food with some rice and also some Mexican beans.
صراحة الأكل جداً رائع، وفيه الطعم المكسيكي فعلاً اللي كان ودنا نتذوقه. يعني صراحة ما يعلى على هالأكل. بس قولي لي، جربتي الأكل القطري؟
I'm very very happy you like it. Out of Qatari food, I like mashbous.
مشبوس. جربتي الهريس؟
نعم. Sorry, no.
ما جربتي.
عندي لك مفاجأة. وهذه المفاجأة الحين جاية.
واو. Yes. That is exciting.
وأنا بعد. وهذا هو الهريس القطري.
Oh my god.
مصنوع من اللحم والقمح أو ممكن دجاج أيا كان وشوية ملح وانتهى الموضوع. خليني أقدم لك.
Wow, delicious. This is excellent.
طبعا احنا من فوق لازم نحط عليه شوية دهنة. فأتمنى الهريس يعجبك وتفضلي.
And this is something you would cook yourself?
طبعا في كل بيت قطري احنا نطبخه.
واو.
عجبت؟ سعادة السفيرة علميني شلون تقولون بالمكسيكي فيه العافية صحتين؟
I would like to teach you how to say buen provecho.
Buen provecho?
Buen provecho. This is a sentence you say when you are about to eat.
Buen provecho.
Exactly. That's perfect. So, what about you?
ايش حابة تعرفين بالعربي؟
Yes, that would be lovely.
خلينا نقول مثلا جملة شكرا جزيلا سعادة السفيرة. شكرا.
شكرا.
جزيلا.
جزيلا.
Gracias.
Excellent.